The U.S. Senate for the great state of Maryland. Currently is Queen Anne's County Commissioner and President of the Commissioner, Dr. Wargotz. Dr. Eric Wargotz is an experienced leader and activist, a physician, businessman, conservative, and conservationist. He has been rated as one of America's top physicians 6 years running, has served on the Potomac Regional Red Cross Advisory Board, been a former governor's appointee to the Board of Physician Quality Assurance, a former president of Queen Anne's County Medical Society. Sounds like he knows something about health care. Please welcome Dr. Wargotz.
Good afternoon. Yeah. It's our life. It's our United States. Take care of it. Take it back. When did being a member of a movement, Tea Party movement, or using the word patriot become a bad word in the media? I want you to tell me, all the media here, tell us, when did it become one of the FCC couple of words you're not supposed to look at? I want to know. Fellow patriots, I'm Eric Wargotz, and I'm running for U.S. Senate against Barbara Mikulski. Thank you. I'm a real doctor. I don't play one on Capitol Hill. Damn right. I know the detriment, the health and financial disaster which awaits us all with the new health care mandate. A few talking points. Thanks to AFP. I want to thank AFP for being the lead sponsor here. The new Obama, Pelosi, Reid, Mikulski health care takeover includes almost $564 billion new taxes on American families and businesses. Let's hear boos, yeah. America is being bankrupted. If the Bush tax cuts are allowed to expire on December 31st of this year, and it looks like the leadership is talking about that, then we'll see almost a $1 trillion tax increase. Yeah, the death tax will come roaring back. The majority party wants to bring back the death tax at an unbelievable 55% rate. The top personal income tax rate will go back to 39.6%. Taxes will go through the roof on capital gains. 47% of Americans no longer pay personal income tax. Probably today, there's a few more I would expect. But that's due to the policies coming out of Washington. So guess where the burden's gonna fall, folks? On the remaining most productive Americans that keep working. With all these tax increases and resulting revenue, you might think they'd have the common sense to at least propose a balanced budget. But no, we don't hear anything about that. And we're expecting a deficit at the end of this year over $1.5 trillion. Taxing and spending is killing prosperity for Americans. Personal income is down 3.2% since the president took office. As government gets bigger, opportunity and economic prosperity for Americans regresses. Now look, like the Tea Party patriots of years gone by, we stand here today, I stand here with you, in opposition to this federal government, in favor of lower taxes, less government, freedom, and liberty! Freedom is for those who are willing to fight for it. We must restore liberty. It's time. Whether Republican, Democrat, or Independent, it doesn't matter. We're all in this mess together, and it's going to take all of us to get us out. Exactly. Thank you. Well, in times of crisis, we must return to our roots, where we came from, our founding principles to find the answers. Quite simply, the Constitution must be respected and adhered to, and not used as a doormat by Congress. Fiscal responsibility through implementation of a balanced budget must find its way into the congressional handbook. And the health care mandate, something I know a little about, must be repealed and revised, and then we will rejoice. God bless you. God bless America. Thank you.